Hi there, this is René Molenaar for IT Video Lessons, and I'd like to talk to you about spanning tree. So, what is spanning tree? Let's take a look. First of all, I want to show you Ether channel. And so, what is Ether channel? If you take a look at the two switches above, we got two switches and there are three different links between them. And those are fast Ethernet links. What I can do with Ether channel, is that I can combine these three links and turn them into a logical link. So it's going to become a virtual link. And the good thing is that, first of all, it will do load balancing between the three different links that we have. And the second thing is that we can combine the bandwidth. So this single Ether channel will become a 300 Mbit link. Now, why do I show you Ether channel here? Because once we start talking about spanning tree is a protocol which will make sure that we have no loops in our switched network. And if we create a Ether channel, then spanning tree will see the Ether channel as a single link. All right, enough about Ether channel. Let's talk a bit about redundancy. What we want to make sure is that we have a network which has no single point of failure. So in the example that we have here, I got two switches, but we got a link on the top side and at the bottom side. So if one of those links would fail, then the switches are still connected to each other, and we will have connectivity. Now, the problem that we have with redundancy is that we will have a loop. And some of the things that we might encounter are broadcast storms, multiple frame copies, and MAC database instability. Now, we're going to talk about those a little bit later. But what I want to show you is that, let's say I have this network. And, for example, this computer over here on the top left is going to send a broadcast because it could be an ARP request. Now, what will happen with a broadcast frame is that the switch will forward it on every port except the port where it came from. So the switch will forward it to the other switch. And then this switch will do the same thing. Forward this broadcast to out of all of the ports that it has, except the port where it came from. So it will forward it over here. And this switch will do the same thing with this frame again. There we go. Forward it, and forward it, and it will keep going. And of course, it will also go the other way around. There we go. So what we have here is a loop, and that's something we don't want to happen. In an Ethernet frame, there is no time to live field. So this Ethernet frame will be flooded over and over again. And the only thing we can do against this is make sure that we disconnect our cable. Otherwise, our data will keep looping around until a network is so slow and people start complaining. And perhaps even my switch could crash. So we don't want loops in our network. So here's an example of what I just showed you. So the computer on the top left is sending a broadcast. And this broadcast will be forwarded out of all of the ports that the switch has. Except the one where it came from. So here's the broadcast storm again. Computer A, the top left one, is sending a broadcast frame. And the switches will just keep forwarding it. And of course, the computer that we have on the bottom right, host B, it will also receive all of those broadcast frames. Now, something else that could happen is what we call... So, this example, this is the broadcast storm that we have. Something else is what we call a multiple frame copy. Now, in this example, what is going to happen the two switches that I have, they don't know about the MAC address of host B on the bottom right. So host A is going to send something meant for host B. It will reach both of these switches, but these switches, they don't know the MAC address, so they will flood it out of the ports. And it's possible that our host on the bottom right, host B, will receive the same frame twice. Now, that could be a problem, maybe not. It depends on the computer that we have. But it's not a good thing that it will receive the same frame twice. Now, what else could happen? Over here, MAC database instability. Because we have frames going around, it's possible that the switches will... So take a look at switch A. That the first time it will think that the MAC address of host B is on port fast Ethernet 0. And then it will believe that it's on port 1. And then it will believe that it's on port 0 again. Because this Ethernet frame is being sent on multiple segments. So the solution to all of these problems is spanning tree. And what we want to do with spanning tree is making sure that we have redundancy, but that it is loop free. What spanning tree is going to do is just making sure that we're going to block one of the ports. So if I block one of the ports, we don't have a loop anymore and we don't have all of these problems. Now, what spanning tree is going to do is going to block one of the ports that we have, and you can see the red cross at the bottom right. That's the non-designated port, and spanning tree is going to block the non-designated port. I'll show you an example of spanning tree, but first let me show you the BPDU, which is called the Bridge Protocol Data Unit, and the BPDU is being sent between all of the switches in my network. The BPDU is used for the spanning tree calculation. Now, there are two fields in this BPDU. The first one is the priority, and it has a default value of 32768. And the second thing that is in the BPDU is the MAC address. Now, the priority and the MAC address, those values together, we call this the bridge ID. And the bridge ID, that's what we're going to use for the spanning tree calculation.